Hey guys, Blue Diva coming to you with a requested tutorial. This is going to be the look that I wore the other day in the video where I did the review for Diva Designs. And you're going to need a few things for this particular look. I apologize if my camera is acting a little weird, because it is acting a little weird. So if you see the video pause like intermittently, I do apologize. I don't know what's wrong with my camera. I'm working on getting a new one. So anyway, on to the tutorial. You're going to need a few things for this particular look. Not this look, but the look that I had. You're going to need, first, of course, you're going to need Lejre or any type of curly wig. This is my very first Lejre, and I am holding on to her like my life depended on it or something. But, and I have others, I don't know why I just won't let this one go. But I feel like the older curly wigs get, the better they get. Look, I got pins still in her. That is so sad. So wow, I really do have pins in her. Okay, so yeah, I feel like the older wigs, curly wigs get like this, the better it looks. So you're going to need Lejre or some type of curly half wig, or you can use your own hair if your hair is big enough for it. You're going to also need bobby pins. I prefer these big jumbo ones because it holds so much better and you can use less. And also you're going to need some type of gel to slick your edges to the side, because this is one of those really neat slicked up edges type of styles. Okay, so what you need to do is, if you're using a half wig, is pretty much just separate, kind of like on an angle if you can, separate like this from here, kind of like from the middle of your head, going all the way down to the nape of your head. So all of this, because you want to have some back to cover up too. Okay, so you're gonna need some hair out, basically is what I'm saying. Okay, and then you can, you know, put the rest in a ponytail or whatever, because that's gonna all be under Lejre or your half wig or whatever type of hair you're gonna use. So I'm just gonna put my hair in a little ponytail like so. I mean, unless your hair is braided or something, you can just, you know, keep it braided. But you need some hair out to cover up the side. And if you can, just try to, like, you know, tuck it down a little bit so it doesn't look too bulky. But I mean, it doesn't really matter, because Lejre is big as ever. So this is the Vanessa Lejre, and you want to put her on just like you would normally. Okay, so this is how I put her on me. I put the comb in the back like so, hold it in place, and bring her forward. Okay, make sure the comb in the back is in place. Okay, now of course it looks crazy because this part here is not pulled down like this side is, but that's okay, because we want to pull all of that over as much as you can. If you want to pull some to the front, you can do that too. It really is up to you. No style is the same. Like this style right now is not going to probably look the same as I did the other day, but that's okay. Alright, so as you can see where I'm going with this, right? So the back is pulled down too, but you're going to use hair to cover that part up. You follow me? Okay. So what you want to do now is take whatever gel you decide to use. I'm going to use my Joey My Gel because it's my favorite now. Looks like this. Okay. And use my trusty old toothbrush, dirty toothbrush that I use for slicking my edges down. And you pretty much want to just slick your edges down like so. Now I just do my edges, like I don't do like all the way up to the top. I just do my edges, but it's totally up to you how you want to do it. Okay, so So you get all that in there, like so. Okay. So the first thing you want to do is cover up the back. And you want to use a bobby pin to hold that in place. Okay. And pretty much what you're going to do is just kind of work your way around and just continue to pin. Like so. I don't know if you guys can see. And this is why I like these big jumbo ones, because it grabs a lot of hair. Okay. So that's three pins so far. Let me move back so you guys can see. This is pin number four. Try to, when you pin it, try to go under the netting of the wig. That way you're pretty much pinning the wig down also. Okay. I need some more. Okay, so I got five in there so far. Now, it really depends on how many pins you want to use. But just for video purpose, we're going to just say that's enough. Now at this point, all you need to do is now is just pretty much kind of blend the hair like over top of, if any of your hair is still showing, you can try to, you know, try to blend your hair over top of that part by doing, you know, some teasing like so. Especially the back, you want to make sure the back is covered. I don't know if I got the back, but make sure the back is completely covered. Okay, get all your beady bees. I'm going to take another pin and pin this right here because it looks too poofy. So basically what it's turning out to be is like one of those, you know, 80s side ponytail that was kind of like developed back in the 80s, Cyndi Lauper time. Some of y'all are like, who? Cyndi Lauper. Google her, okay? She is the fiercest white chick ever, besides Madonna. So anyway, this is it, you guys. Now, it's really up to you, again, how wild you want it, how much you want it in your face, how much, if you want to pull some baby hairs out, go. Do it. It's your style, you know? Make it yours. Work it out. But yeah, that's all it really is. It's just legit. With some of your hair pulled out, and I like to use the gel to slick my edges up because it kind of gives you that, you know, I got some waves over my hair, so it kind of makes you look like, you know, this is really your hair. But you know, it's all fun. So this is a really cool way to wear LeJay, other than just wearing her down. You could pull her up on the side, and of course, you know, there's the number of styles you can do with this is endless. You can of course take out hair on this side and pull it up over this way, make it a mohawk. You can do whatever you want, but I'm feeling the side because it makes me feel like I got a little swag. And this is a really, really cute style, you guys, for the holidays, too. If you're going to a party, if you're going out for New Year's, Christmas Eve, whatever, this is a really cute style because it's kind of up, like an updo, but it's still kind of chic and, you know, kind of classy, you know, throw a little bit of lip gloss on whatever and you're cute. So that's it, you guys. If you have any questions, let me know. But that's it. Talk to you guys later.